Hello everybody, this is Big Lou again. Sorry about that. My phone fell off the passenger side seat. I guess that trick didn't work. So I guess I'll call the other video, driving from Southwest Miami to West Perrine. And this one I'll call it driving from West Perrine to, I don't know, depends how far south I go. I heard there's a way you can trim this video. I don't know how to do that. So, I hate holding the phone as I'm walking. I'd rather just strap it in front of my chest or my waist or something. I wonder if the Apple stores sell something like that, to where you can just strap it around your head or your waist or your shoulder. Now, if I put it behind my belt, that might work. But I might want to put some extra tape. I don't know if the tape is going to work. I just need it. Something to secure it so it doesn't fall. Yesterday we had a plane that skidded across the runway at Miami International Airport. I don't know if you heard about it. It kind of crash landed on the runway. And I think I know why it did that. There was a big gaping hole in front of the plane. And I heard the landing gear wasn't down, wasn't locked properly. It looked like the wheels were sideways. I'm not sure. But I'll find out later on exactly what happened. But I saw the video as the plane landed. It landed kind of sideways, like at a 340 degree angle. It shifted towards the left a little bit, and as it did that, the plane caught on fire. no wheels. It looked like it didn't have any wheels. You know? It looks like they didn't even lower the land gear. So yeah, it caught on fire on one side, which was the right side of the plane. And it went to a stop, and as soon as it went to a stop, a bunch of fire trucks, emergency vehicles, fire rescues, and I think there was an ambulance, went towards the plane, as well as Miami-Dade police. And you can see a bunch of people jumping on one of those inflatable rafts, leaving the plane. There were three reported injuries. Nothing life-threatening, thank God. And everybody escaped the injury. Left because this lane merges. Okay. Now I can make the left. Peruvian restaurant. Oh, they have a Peruvian restaurant. I don't think I ever tried Peruvian food before. They used to have an Indian restaurant by my house, but they closed it down and went out of business. I never had Indian food either. But I've had Haitian food a few times, and it's really good. They have rice and pork. This Haitian restaurant that I went to in Little Haiti, which is near downtown Miami, it's called Chef Creole. They have a couple of them in Miami. They have one in Little Haiti, and they have another one in, what, North Miami? Yeah. They give you a whole bunch of food for like $9.99, $10, $11. It's a good deal. Put a lot of rice, a lot of pork. It's pretty cheap, you know. It's about the same price as paying for pepper steak and onions at a Chinese place, which is, what, $9? I don't know if it's still $9. I think the price went up to, I think it's more than $9 now. And here we are, we're entering Goulds, Florida, which has a population of about 35,000 people. I think they have a two-bedroom, two-bathroom house in Goulds for $380,000. Last time I checked. If you go to Zillow.com, which is located in the southwestern part of Miami. It's close to shopping center, movie theater, Church's Chicken. But I heard that shopping center is going to close down, build some apartments. Which is really sad. That includes the movie theater that might shut down because the movie theater's in the mall. And it's close to Family Dollar for those of you that like to shop on a budget. There's also Pinecrest Bakery, which is open. I think it's open 24 hours, but they have Latin food. It's a Latin restaurant. Oh, they have a billboard sign on the right, TNT Fireworks, largest selection available. Oh, but that's in Fort Lauderdale. The one in Key Largo is much closer than the one in Dania Beach, which is in Fort Lauderdale. I've been to the one in Key Largo. When you go there, you have to show them your driver's license before buying entry, before buying anything, fireworks. I don't know why they do that, but, you know, I can't remember the name of that place where they sell fireworks in Key Largo. There's the Redland Market Village, which is a flea market. It's open on the weekends. It's also open during the week because I see a bunch of cars parked. They sell pizza. They have a little restaurant where they sell pizza. And on the left, they have a Mexican restaurant called Puerta de Vallarta. And then they also have one on the right, which is called El Nuevo Reconcito. I'm not sure if that's, I don't think that's Mexican. I don't know. Because we have several Reconcito restaurants in Miami, and I've been to one of them in Westchester, which is located in southwest Miami. I used to live in Westchester years ago. You'll see some new condominiums that are being built. And this is the ranch that we're entering. We're no longer in homes. These look nice. Around here, they're going to have to build more schools. They're going to have to build an elementary school, middle school, and a high school. And there's some condos on the right. Those are new. On the left. Wow. And condos on the right. And there's condos on the left. A new condo right there. Now leasing 1, 2, and 3 bedroom apartments. I'm trying to get the phone number on that one in case you all are interested in moving to Naranja. That's another low priced area to move in. You can buy a house here for less than $500,000. Three bedroom, two bath. Yeah, the phone number is 786-601-21079. In case you all are interested. temperature outside is 90 degrees Fahrenheit. Selection of consoles and games for sale. Oh God, going 40 miles an hour. Why am I going so slow? And here they have more cargos on the left. Those are new. Condo on the right. Years ago, they used to have an apartment building on the left, low-income housing. And they had to tear it down. Those residents, they had to move out. And on the left, there are some more condos. Wow, we're building up around here. Building up some more homes. It's hot outside. AC's working hard to keep me cool. But when I'm driving at night, the AC in this car is really cold. So that's when I put it on the lowest setting. And I close this one vent on the left. But in San Francisco, it's kind of cold year round. During the day, it's cool, it's never hot, especially in June, but at night, it's kind of cold, or cold, I should say. I know because I've been to San Francisco one time. There are certain parts of San Francisco where it's about 900 feet above sea level. But the incline of those roads are really steep. You know, if you watch it on TV or in a movie, I like San Francisco, it's a nice city, especially Los Angeles, Beverly Hills. I've been to those cities as well. California is really beautiful. I've never been to the beaches in California. I should have gone beaches like what, Venice Beach, Los Angeles Beach. I've never been there. Wow, now it's up to 91 degrees. It's never been over 95 degrees in Miami. I mean, the most it's ever been is probably about 93. I seen it go up to 93, but 95, I don't know, I think 95 has been the most it's ever gone up to. Havana Spice Restaurant, that's a Cuban restaurant. Now when you're visiting Homestead, there's a bunch of motels and hotels. I think the cheapest motel would be Park Motel. Mario's Cuban Cuisine. I gotta try that place. Floridian Hotel. Heated Pool. Heated Pool is a must. I wish all these hotels have a heated pool. I'm kind of hesitant when I go inside of a swimming pool because most of these pools that I have gone in, it's really cold. there's one that I've been to. I used to use this pool a lot, and it's always been warm during the summer. And it's not even a pool. But it's nice, it's clean, the water's clear. It's not dirty or anything. It's a pretty big pool. Okay, now we're entering, I just left Homestead and now we're entering Florida City. Florida City, there's about maybe 25,000-30,000 people. The rent is cheaper than Homestead in Miami as far as buying a home. Some of the homes go for less than $500,000 for a three-bedroom, two-bath. It's close to restaurants, hotels, diners, fast food places. And you got a 7-Eleven. You got IHOP. You got an auto parts store, it's called O'Reilly. And you got Florida City Dental on the right hand side. There's a bunch of restaurants. Such as, okay, you got Waffle House. And you got Texas Roadhouse. I've never been to Texas Roadhouse before. I always wanted to visit that restaurant. I've been wanting to eat there. And there's a few banks such as Chase Bank and Aldi, which is a supermarket. And you got Babcock Home Furniture, Sonny's Barbecue, you got a Best Buy, GameStop, Walmart. Well, actually, it's called Super Walmart. Half of that store is a grocery store, and the other half is where you can buy items such as clothes, electronics. Things to buy for your vehicle. Such as what? New wiper blades, fog lights. There's also a Honda dealership on the right-hand side. That's where my sister bought her vehicle. I think the reason why she went all the way down south to that Honda dealership was because I guess they had a better deal than the one in Southwest Miami. Well, Paul Gables, I don't know. Hotels. These have just been built, and they have a Cracker Barrel. Look at that, gas is $4.79 at Romero. Wow. $4.78 at Exxon. Well, they have more hotels, they have a Best Western. That one's neat. Holiday Express, yeah, that one's kind of new. Probably almost 5 years old, so. Missing Child Alert. Gray 2013 Dodge Dart. Florida Tag QFG E59. And they have a racetrack on the right. It's 478. This is the last gas station before headed towards the Keys. And there you have the Last Chance Saloon, which is a bar and a liquor store. That's the last chance before you can buy any liquor store to the Keys. Okay, now I'm headed towards the Keys, which is about 20 miles. So I should be there in about almost 25 minutes. Sandal Factory is a store where you can buy swimwear, such as bathing suit sandals, and they have 5 t-shirts for $10. It's really cheap. Key Largo, 16 miles. So I should be there in about 20 minutes from now. It's 2:39 p.m. Again, it's 2:39 in the afternoon. Passing zone, head 1 mile. I can't wait to pass this white vehicle in front of me. But I'm not saying he's going too slow, but you know, at least he's going, you know, speeding. Well, at least he's not going too fast. He's doing about 65. few people put, you know, hateful comments on the channel. Saying that, what, she's old, fat, and, you know, she's not fat, you know, that's for sure. She just has an average type body. Not nice to discriminate people, especially, you know, older people. I mean, regardless of their race and gender, you know. I love driving down this stretch of highway. No traffic. You have the whole highway to yourself. It's like you're driving in the country. I feel safer that they built this blue barrier, this blue, light blue median in the middle. Because they didn't have that, and there were several head-on collisions every year. Ever since they built that about 10 years ago, it has reduced the amount of head-on collisions. So I pretty much feel safer driving at night to the Keys. I wish they would build a four-lane highway where you have two lanes going south and two lanes going north. I mean, they do have two lanes going south and two lanes going north that extend for about a half a mile. I mean, those are passing zones. They have two of them. But they need to do more than that to reduce the amount of traffic. at Key Largo. And here we have the visitor center. Okay, I'm gonna make a pit stop. I'm gonna pull over and use the restroom. I hate it when this happens, especially on my stream. But I'm gonna leave the camera on. I'll be really quick. I should be back in a couple of minutes. Sorry about that, guys. Be right back. Okay, I'm back, guys. I had to block this crazy person on my stream that was commenting. Well, anyways, I'm not going to get into that. been streaming for an hour and 3 minutes.